aka.ms/SQL Workshops has a wealth of resources for you to use to learn and share and present with your friends, colleagues, and customers. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Buck Woody, a principal data scientist on the Azure data team. Thanks for being with us today, Buck.
Anna, thank you so much for having me. Really privileged to be here.
It's amazing this show has gone on for so long and we haven't had you on the show yet. So I'm excited for this and hopefully many more in the future.
Absolutely.
And today we're going to be talking about SQL workshops. Now, I know you have a lot of stuff to show everyone and, you know, you're going to help guide me through the website. But can you start by telling us kind of why we did SQL workshops, what it is, and, you know, that sort of thing?
Yeah. So I rejoined the SQL team after many years. I'd been on the SQL team when I first started at Microsoft, and then I rejoined. And when I did, I was asked, hey, can you help the adoption? People use our stuff. And for people to use our stuff, they have to know how it works. They have to want to use it, and they have to know how it works. And so Bob Ward and myself and you got together, and I said, hey, why don't we put this thing on GitHub, and we put a repository of deep, really useful training materials. And I'll make it look nice, and we'll get a template going and everything like that. And Anna, you went, yeah, sounds good. And Bob said, whatever. And then he saw it and he said, this is awesome. And so we started following that process. And so it kind of was born it's been about 18 months ago, We started this. And it's amazing the uptake. It gets thousands of hits a month. Pulling down the content and working with it. And the interesting thing is when we teach you and myself and Bob together and individually, and now even other people at Microsoft, we use it to drive the classroom. When we teach, we're in this site, which I think is amazing.
Awesome. Thanks, Buck. And yeah, it's been a really great experience and it's come a long way. And I think a lot of people are seeing a lot of value from it. Let's go ahead and take a look.
Yeah. So I'll tell you what, why don't you bring it up and I'll walk you like you're a student going through the materials themselves. We'll just click in a few places, kind of show people how it works. Okay, well, here we are. Anna, thanks for navigating to this. And the main part here, I think that's the most important, is the link that's prominently displayed there. It's a short link, aka.ms/SQL workshops. And that's the link that will expand into actually a GitHub. We've got a nice, good-looking view here, but it's actually GitHub behind the scenes. Now, if you'd like to learn more about how GitHub works, we even have links for that in here, too. I think something that's interesting to note, Anna, if you scroll up just a little bit, it says more about that process is here. The way GitHub works, if you want to right-click that, the more about the process, then it shows you how to clone the repository. If you're not familiar with Git, that's a fancy way to say it copies it down to your hard drive. And then anything you change on your local hard drive stays with you. It doesn't come back up into the GitHub at all. So that's a great thing that you can use. And by the way, we want you to take this site, change it, use it again somewhere else. We're fine with that. The license is down at the bottom. It's open source. You can go for it. We don't mind a bit. We do keep it up to date. So I think the most important thing to realize is all the different kinds of content are on here. You can see there in the SQL Server data platform area, there is a workshop, and then there's a lab, and then there's a video series, all of those together. A workshop, when Anna and Bob and myself and the others who joined in here at Microsoft, when we build those are usually longer than 4 hours. In fact, some of them are 9 hours. They're a bit long. All of them are made to be taken in person. You can take them with us at the forefront of the class teaching, or you can take them online yourself. Everything we do is made to be done both ways. So they're very self-guided and they're very in-depth. And then we also have labs, and labs are usually 2 to 4 hours, sometimes even just an hour. Many times a workshop will contain a lab, but the lab is a little more bounded and so on. We're very careful within our materials that we build here to make sure we use as many free resources as we can. So in most cases, it won't cost you anything to do any of these. We've got a full video series on Data Exposed. Hey, that's this program, I think. So that's pretty awesome. And then we've got a few other courses. We've kind of bundled them up. You saw the SQL Server one there, and Anna's now pointing at the SQL Azure or Azure SQL ones, and you can see the video series we have in that. We've got some programming labs for you as well, and a workshop on R for data professionals and Python for data professionals. So both of those are available to you. And then we spend a great deal of time, Anna and I both love the AI space, and so we've got a machine learning with SQL Server course, end to end, take you all the way through. And throughout the courses, something that's really important, Anna, to mention to everyone, is that within the course, there's a lot of links. We use a lot of links. So when you see a word that's hyperlinked, right-click and open that in a new window for sure, because we spin off to a lot more in-depth topics. So let's say we're talking about deep learning. We're not just going to say it and move on. We've got a full course for you out on the web for deep learning as well. But Anna, another thing that's very exciting in here is the materials. We've got presentation materials. Maybe right click on that one and open in a new tab for me. And let's show everybody kind of what we've got available to us. Look at all the stuff we've got here. Bob Ward's presentations. He puts all of his stuff out there, the slide decks, everything. He wants you to use it. The Tiger team. All of their presentations are out there. We've got Bob's, the Bobs, if you've ever heard of them, the Bob Ward and his friends that post materials out there. You've got my presentations, and we've got this person named Anna Hoffman, who's got a really killer set of stuff out there as well. And then we've got all of the SQL Server GitHub thing. And then Pedro, one of the gentlemen inside the Tiger team here at Microsoft, keeps these links up to date. Look at what you've got here. Look at all the stuff that you can find with quick links. A lot of people never come in here, but it's a rich wealth. Let's go back to the main site for a moment, and I'll show you a couple of other cool things in here, Anna. One of the big things now is this learning how to learn. Everybody's having to do on-prem learning and at-home learning with their kids. We've actually got two courses in here for you. One is a data literacy course, and it shows you high school to the C-level how to work with data in general, just data literacy skills. Really useful course. We've taught it at high schools, and we've taught it in boardrooms as well. So that's a wonderful course to dive into. And then we've also got a learning how to learn course. Now, that's actually not ours. It's on Coursera. And the other day I read, and it is a hugely popular course now, but that's been in there for 18 months. Well, one final thing. Scroll all the way back to the top, if you don't mind. And the final thing I wanted to mention was, what if they find a problem? What if something's wrong a little bit and they're not sure what to do? In typical GitHub, you would pull the clone down, you'd work on it, and you would check back in with a branch, and then that would be merged and so on. This is a course or like a book, so we don't really do that. There's a link right there that says, post an issue here. So if you click that, it will go in that GitHub to the issues, and you could say new issue. And what we'd like you to do, if you think something's wrong or should be changed, we want you to paste the link to the page you're wanting changed, and then just make a new issue, paste the link in there, and say, hey, you should probably talk about the fact that artificial neural networks are different than global or adversarial neural networks or whatever. So that's the general rundown. It's a wealth of information inside this site. And once again, back on the main site there, that URL is aka.ms/SQL workshops.
Thanks, Buck. That was really a wealth of resources. And, you know, to be honest, I didn't realize how many references Pedro had put in there. Like, that's a lot of stuff. That's going to become my new place to go to find stuff.
Oh, and he keeps that up to date. He will ping me and say, I need this entered. So he keeps it up to date.
That's awesome. Now, another thing I wanted to mention, you know, since this is out on the web and it's open source, you know, if I don't work at Microsoft and I want to use this content to make a SQL Saturday presentation or deliver a workshop or even like use it with my customers, is that something that I can do with these resources?
Absolutely. The license is mentioned down there at the bottom. You are welcome to take it and do whatever you'd like to. I'd mention one thing. We're going to keep ours up to date. So if you clone it, you'll want to come back in from time to time and refresh the information so that you can do that again. We actually try to keep the graphics to a minimum and the logos to a minimum so that you can reuse it. We're excited to see what people will do with the information.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much, Buck, for kind of giving us a tour of SQL Workshops and explaining what actually is in it. You know, people maybe have been hearing about it for a long time. We really appreciate having you on the show, and we hope to have you again on the show sometime soon. For our viewers, thanks for joining us. If you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and leave us a comment to let us know what you've done or will do with SQL Workshops. See you next time on Data Exposed.